Let's make sense of the newly appointed cabinet under the disguise, under this so-called government of national unity, right? Now, people have been reacting from this, and I'm going to start with ISAP too. This union have said that they are specifically unhappy with the appointment of Gwarubes, right? So in other words, they are saying Gwarube's appointment is really something that is not made sure. Now, Gwarube is a DA member or MP that has gotten a position. So in this episode, I seek to give you clarity as to as people were reacting to the to this whole thing. What did Sabtu say about this? Now, there is an article written by Janet Shabalala, right, under the Sowetan Live. The article, I've already told you the heading of the article. They are very much displeased with the Minister of Basic Education, Siviwe Gwarube. Right. South African Democratic Teachers Union, SABTU, has expressed its disappointment in the appointment of DA Siviwe Gwarube as new basic education minister, saying President Cyril Ramaphosa appointed her fully aware of her strained relationship with the union and her party. Now, let me give you a bit of a details on this one. You might, look, I've done a video about this, and I told you that some people are not happy with, some people have said that if Ramaphosa chooses to work with EDA, he must expect this country that is going to be chaotic, right? This country is going to be in chaos. So I need to unpack all of this, because this other union said, it's a metal water union, right? They said that, you know what? If Ramaphosa continue to work with this DA, the DA that wants to do away with some of the things and want to enforce its policies, they should be aware that this country will be ungovernable if that's the case. Having said that, this another union pointing out at one of the DA MP saying, this one, we will deal with her. It's not what I say, it's what they said. But there's one thing that I also know for a fact that we need to do in this YouTube channel. It is this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contributing to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay, so let's go. Ramaphosa announced his new cabinet, his new national executive on Sunday night, promising that the incoming government will be effective and will comprise people with experience and skills and capabilities to deliver on its mandate. What's the mandate, by the way? Because it's another thing to say people will deliver on the mandate, but what's the mandate? Because it's one thing to be promised the land of milk and honey, but it's another thing to describe the land of milk and honey. Like, we don't understand. Like, people must tell us, when you elect somebody, that person must tell you that, okay, this is what we are seeking to achieve. What's the mandate? You just keep hearing about the mandate. What is the mandate? However, on Monday, Subject General Secretary Magwenya Maluleke said Gwarube was an upfront to the union and that the DA has always made the union its enemy number one. He said, the DA refused to acknowledge the role of colonial and apartheid education systems, which entrenched inequalities for centuries and decades, but puts the blame on SAPTU. Teachers and learners, therefore, no amount of persuasion can convince SAPTU that the DA accepted the position to ensure quality and unequitable education. And equitable education. Their motive is to weaken the union, in particular SAPTU. We will see. Our Meshula. They said, even its election manifesto declared war against SAPTU, lamenting that the union was too strong and must be dealt with. I did not hear that, but if they did say that, it's worrisome. It's really a worrisome. That means Ramaphosa appointing this person knew exactly that there's going to be enmity, or the power that was invested in them was to give them the... But if Ramaphosa did that, that means Ramaphosa, vele Ramaphosa, he's NDA. What DA hates, Ramaphosa hates. But that's the easiest conclusion I can arrive at to say, no man, it can't be. It really can't be. But let's continue. There's something off about our president. I'm telling you, there's something off about this man. We will wake up one day. I'm telling you. He said, it said it believes that the failure of the education systems are because of the ANC's allowed our education system to be captured by the vested interest of SAPTU, right? Those are some of the words that the person who speaks for SAPTU said. Maluleke and SAPTU was interested in seeing social justice and equitable, equal and quality public education and for teachers to have their academic and professional freedom respected and their labor right protected as workers. Which, to be quite honest, I think it's a fair request. This one, guys, that's a fair request. Very, very fair. Meanwhile, the National Professional Teachers Organization of SA Basil Manuel said they do not know Gwarube and her credential, but they hope she will serve South Africa. She will serve well, right? In the tenure of the last minister, Angie Motshekga, we have seen calm within education. We haven't had disruption for the part of the 13 years. And maintaining that is important. We need continuation of the level of engagement and the level of working with unions. I mean, I'm going to ask this question. Is it such a difficult thing to ask? I don't think so. I really don't think so. I think it's just one of those reasonable demands that they are bringing on the table. From where I'm seated, I think it's one of those reasonable demands. But what's your take about the request? It's up to say. ETA, guys, they are suspects in everything. Nobody trusts them. They turn left, right, left. We are fun and nobody trusts them. I don't know why. Because I don't trust them. I don't trust them, guys. Honestly speaking, I don't trust them. Right?